Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome back to FaceVis. I'm Manas Sharma, and in this tutorial, I'll be showing you guys how to automatically download the molecular structures of a bunch of molecules, provided that you know their names. So given a list of molecules by their names, you will be able to automatically download their molecular structures using Python and PubChem by the end of this tutorial. Now, this is really an important or a crucial skill if you're working in the field of chem informatics or artificial intelligence or machine learning, where you might need to download these structures for training your machine learning model, or perhaps generating data for your machine learning model by running some simulations on these molecular structures. In this tutorial, we'll be downloading these structures from the PubChem database, which is a really nice database. This is their website. So the URL is something like this. I will put a link to this URL in the description down below. So essentially, how PubChem database works is you can usually type in the name of the molecule to search for it, and then click on a search result. And once you go to their web page, you can download the structure by clicking over here. So this will give you a 2D structure, but yeah, usually we want the 3D structure. So you can usually download the structure as an SDF file, which is also known as the mol file. And in this tutorial, we'll be automating all this process using Python and the PubChem Py library. So here I have a directory where I have already written the code, that is the Python script that shows you the entire procedure. So let me go ahead and just zoom in a little. So in order to save time, instead of writing this whole code right now, I'll just go through the key portions of this and explain the code to you. So essentially, the code starts by importing the PubChem Py library as PCP. So first of all, you'll need to make sure that you have it installed or not. So open your terminal, and yeah, by the way, I assume in this tutorial that you already have Python installed. If you don't have that, then maybe you can check out my other tutorials or check other resources on the internet. But yeah, so here we will be installing PubChem Py by typing pip install PubChem Py. And by the way, depending on how your system is set up, you may need to use pip 3 install rather than pip install. But yeah, just please ensure that you do the correct thing. Pip usually refers to Python 2, but in my case, it's still working with Python 3 the way I have configured it. So yeah, so I'll do pip install PubChem Py, hit enter. And essentially it will download it. In your case, in my case, I already have it cached, so it doesn't download, but rather just installs it from cache. And we can see that it has been installed successfully. Yeah, so here it is now. Next, as you can see from this script, we also require pandas. So by the way, the OS and requests libraries come with Python built-in, so we only need the pandas library as well, which is again a very common library if you work in the area of machine learning. So yeah, so we'll do pip install pandas as well and hit enter. So in this case, it is downloading the library, and we'll just wait a couple of seconds to download it. Okay, so pandas libraries has been installed successfully as well. So next is the list of compounds that you want to download. So essentially, you provide the names of the molecules. So we have, for example, acetone, benzene, ethanol, methane, propane. Maybe let me add one more to this list. That is caffeine. Yeah, so let's add that. And yeah, next you will specify name for all these structures where the SDF files or the mol files will be downloaded. And then this is the command to create the directory by this name. So the directory where you have the script in, there you will get this directory called structures SDF when you run the code. And then you can also get some properties, some basic properties such as the names of the molecules, that is the IUPAC names, then the formulas, as well as the molecular weights. And then, yeah, this is the most crucial part. So this is the function that basically downloads the SDF, provided the compound ID in the PubChem database. So CID is the compound ID in the PubChem database. You send this to this function, and it basically queries this URL, and plugs in the compound ID and requests for the 3D record type, that is the 3D molecular structure and the SDF, that is, and then essentially you just get the response and return this response as text. Next, of course, so this is another main part, that is you loop through all the moles, or that is the all the molecules in the molecules list. So we call that by the variable name mol. So for mol in molecules, that is for acetone, benzene, and so on, then you will essentially use the PubChem Pi library. So we imported it as PCP. So you'll use this get compounds function from the PubChem Pi library, where you provide the name of the molecule, because the molecules list contains the names. So for the first iteration, it will contain acetone. So yeah, so at the first iteration, this mol contains the name acetone, and then this quotes name basically means that we are querying the database for a molecule by the name. So how we are searching for it is by name. And then the zero here essentially mean the zero in square brackets essentially mean that we want this compound variable to get the first result that is returned by this. So it may return many results, but we only care about the first result, because that would be the closest match, of course. And then essentially you can, as we already created these empty lists before, to store some basic informations. So essentially you can now append information to these lists by typing names.append and then compound that was returned from the PubChem database dot IUPAC name, which is an attribute that this compound object has. And so then the names list will get this IUPAC name, then the formula name in a similar fashion using this molecular formula attribute, and similar fashion you will get the weights using this molecular weights attribute. And then here's a fun part, you download the SDF using this get SDF function, and then the SDF variable here gets the text of the SDF. So you still need to create a file from that text, and that you can do with this with open function. And then you provide the directory of the SDFs, then the name of the file, and then the extension of the file. And then W here basically means that you're writing the file. So it stands for the write mode. So yeah. So here you might notice that although the file is SDF type, I am saving it with the extension .mol rather than .sdf. That is because most of the software such as Vesta, they read the, mol and SDF are basically the same in my experience. I might be wrong. But yeah, so Vesta is able to read SDF files if they have the mol extension, or essentially it reads the mol file. So that is why I've saved it as .mol. And then f.write will basically write the contents of the SDF variable to a file that we created, or rather opened here. So yeah. And then finally, you can create a data frame with all the data that we had. So we had the names, formulas, and weights as lists. And here you can specify the column header title, that is name, formula, weight, for my Pandas data frame. You may not even need it, but yeah, it's just makes my life easy, because as a machine learning researcher, you probably already have it installed, so why not utilize it? But yeah, so then using this data, so yeah, essentially this is basically creating like a dictionary, because so the name will correspond to this names list, the formula will correspond to the formulas list, and so on. And using this dictionary, you can essentially create the Pandas data frame by using pd.dataframe and then providing this data dictionary over here. And then your data frame will be returned in this df variable. And yeah, and finally you can simply export it as csv. So yeah, so this would be the name of the file, or you can specify any other name, and you can also print the data frame as well. So I hope I have been successful in explaining this code, and now let's essentially just try to run this and see what happens. So first of all, let me clear my terminal, and I will do ls to see what files are there. So as you can see, there is just one file, that is this Python script. This is also how my directory looks right now. And next, what I'm going to do is I'm going to run this script. So I'll do Python and then the name of the file, that is pubchem download.py, and hit enter. and you will see that it is doing something, and immediately you now see that there's a file or directory called structures SDF now created, and already you are seeing that there are some molecules there as well. So it took a while, but by the end, you know, it provided this data frame which contains the names of IUPAC names of the molecules, formulas, molecular weights, and you also have all these structures. You can open them using Vesta. I've created a tons of tutorials on Vesta if you're not familiar with Vesta already. So yeah, so here you can see all these visualizations. So this is your caffeine, this is your benzene, and so on. And if you go back, you can also see this compound CSV, which contains the, you know, the same data frame as a CSV file, so that you can use it for further processing for your machine learning model. You might want to use this as input or descriptors. So I think that is it. Now, although before we end this tutorial, you might also sometimes want to you know, export these molecules as XYZ files rather than mol files, because mol is not a really common common format that many softwares work with. So in order to save these molecules as XYZ instead of mols, or additionally as XYZ format, you can utilize the ASE library. Again, you will have to install it if you don't already have it installed, so you'll do pip install ASE. And then you can, you know, essentially create another directory called, let's say, XYZ, and so structures XYZ, sorry. So we'll add these, this here, and then also make a copy of this line and change it to XYZ. And then finally, when you, you know, and yeah, by the way, what we need is we need to import actually read and write functions from ASE. So what we'll do is from ASE import read comma write, because we are already, you know, writing the SDF file. So essentially what we can do is we can just read those. So now we'll do read, or rather atoms equals read, then we'll do this file name. So this would be the file name that we want to read. You can specify the format as well. So that would be SDF, and then you can do, yeah, so basically this Visual Studio Copilot has already completed the code for me. So yeah, this makes complete sense to me. So let's go ahead and run it. So yeah, so here's what I have right now in my directory, and now I'll run this. Okay, so we have a bit of an error. So it cannot import read from ASE, because that is actually supposed to be in ASE.io. my bad. Okay, now let's run this again. Now you can see you have an additional directory called structure XYZ, but yeah, we have landed another error. So let's check this out. Okay, let me try one more thing. That is, maybe I'll try not specifying the input format and let ASE decide the format by itself. Let's check this out. Okay, yeah, so this seems to be working. Okay, yeah, so maybe SDF format is not really in ASE dictionary by that, but I don't really know. Yeah, so when I don't provide the format, then if I open the acetone XYZ file, then yeah, it works exactly as you would expect. So yeah, so so that is how you essentially download bunch of molecules automatically from the PubChem database using the PubChem PI library and a bit of Python code. And by the way, the link to this code, I leave it in the description before, but actually it's I've also written a blog post on it, so you can go ahead and check out the blog post at this URL. I'll put a link to it in the description down below as well. And yeah, so that is basically it. I hope you guys found this tutorial useful. In case you did, then don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. If you have any questions or doubts, leave them in the comment section down below. Thanks for watching and have a great day.